Time now for a look at your health. And on the heels of Labor Day, a recent study finds that fishermen have the most dangerous job in America. I actually know that personally. My dad was a commercial fisherman in Alaska. It's very dangerous. So that made us think, what are the most common workplace injuries out there? Joining us now is Dr. Mitchell Goldman with more on occupational hazards. Very appropriate after the holiday. Welcome back.
Good to be here.
Good to have you. Let's talk about just how big of a problem this is.
It's actually a huge problem. It basically costs this country about $50 billion a year in direct costs, and almost 50,000 people will die every year from an occupational injury. And as we were saying off camera, it's about 3.5 million people have an occupational injury every year. So these are huge costs, not just financially, but medically as well.
And you're talking health care costs, correct?
Absolutely. It's $50 billion in health care, another $100 billion in associated health care costs. So it costs a lot of money as well.
Well, let's talk about what some of the most common ones are. I know we actually have a graphic built for the viewers at home so they can follow along.
There's so many. One of the common things is, of course, falling and back injuries. And, you know, just if you're sitting down, you have to make sure you're actually sitting in a chair and no one's pulling it out from you or the chair doesn't roll down. Because it might seem funny, especially if it's on a sitcom, but that's a leading cause is back pain from slipping.
And eye strain, we have our list here, and I'm assuming that from the increased use of computers?
Absolutely, and it really plays a toll. Now, eye strain can also make you have headaches because you're using your muscles all the time. So, of course, on many episodes, we've talked about using Botox to stop the muscles from doing it, but it's better to just relax every now and then. Don't really cone in on that computer.
And carpal tunnel is another side effect.
That's another major one for people typing all the time, especially if you're not using word processing by speaking. Carpal tunnel's a major problem.
And you also mentioned proper seating. So do you need to ask your employer? Let's talk suggestions about should I get an ergonomically correct chair or what do you recommend?
It's actually really good to have the proper chairs. And, you know, I'm an employer of about 50 people, and so I make sure that my employees also have proper chairs to sit at because it's that back strain is going to really wreak havoc on your employees.
And that keeps costs down for you as well, so it's also a smart business.
Absolutely,
move.
And a happy employee is a productive employee, and it's a happy business environment.
And how would you say overall, how do you improve safety and in the workplace?
It's all common sense. It's all thinking about what your mom told you to do. Don't run with holding a scissor, for instance. You know, walking is good. When you're picking things up, you don't want to hold things above eye level. You want to hold them down. You want to squat down appropriately. You know, don't try to be a hero and stand up on a chair to reach for something on a top shelf. You know, just play it smart because let's face it, Kathleen, we're mostly in an office more than at home. And although we can be injured at home, we're in the office so often that we do get injured.
And it can be a big strain on us and a big drain on the economy.
So. And the family, everyone.
All right. Dr. G, thank you so much for returning.
Good
and
to
happy
be here.
Honeymoon.
Back to work.
That's right. Labor Day, very appropriate over here. And Lauren, we'll send it to you.
All right. Thank you.